Thank you very much for all the speakers, Pak Dianto, Pak Hendra, yeah, all the audience of this webinar. Yeah, I have the title of my presentation, Impact of COVID-19 on Indonesia Coal Mining. Yeah. This is the structure, the systematic of my presentation, the short-term and long-term impact of COVID. Yeah. What would the industry look like in the post-COVID? And what the opportunity and policy response to harness resilience in mining area, government incentive for mining company during COVID-19. But before we have the conference, we hope the discussion with United States ASEAN Business Council. And this is the presentation of minister, yeah, the impact of COVID-19 on macroeconomics has been taking place the beginning of this year, yeah, and had an impact on change in the social order of life and decrease economic performance, not only in Indonesia, but in the most country in the world. Yeah. COVID-19 has brought about this eruption of regulation, disruption that require revision, basic assumption, justification, and project economy. Indonesian government also refocus of APBN with priority of recovery for this impact of COVID-19. The government will conduct comprehensive evaluation, including of macroeconomic change in the macroeconomic assumption, and also for the mining coal in Indonesia. And there is the omnibus law. Yeah, we have take the advantage of the demographic bonus that we have today. Yeah, especially to get the trap, the middle income trap. Yeah. Responding the biggest challenge of maintaining and providing jobs, simplifying, synchronizing, included the mining law, trimming regulation, the number of rules and regulation, hyper-regulation, which hinder the job creation, and also the instrument and for simplifying and increasing effectiveness of bureaucracy, providing protection convenience, for the MSME and cooperative for enter formal sector through its establishment, licensing and guidance, and creating new job, through increased investment, also in mining investment. But they have many problem in the coal mining investment, because the bank, some of big bank don't give the credit anymore. And also not only in mining and coal mining, but also in the power generation of coal. And this is the improvement of investment ecosystem. This is the change of law, of mining law. The new law is number 3 of 2020, and also concerning of law of oil and gas, and also for geothermal. And this is also regulatory mapping of current foreign exchange proceed derived from natural resources. And this is very detailed, but this is one of regulation that will synchronize with the other regulation in Indonesia. We enter in the chapter 1. What is the short-term and long-term impact of COVID-19 in coal mining sector? Until the first quarter of this year, no significant effect for the mining in Indonesia, not yet until early April 2020. The mineral selling also in early April was also performing well. Yeah, processing refining activity work normally. Yeah, this is the fact in the first quarter of this year. But after that, there is the influence of all the mining in Indonesia. Yeah, and we see in the world, there is the influence also that influence the progress of mining in Indonesia, yeah, in Tiongkok, in India. But in South Korea and Japan, there is no significantly affected by the COVID until now, especially for the import, yeah, but not too significant, yeah. Also in Europe, many influence of decrease due to the shift to renewable energy. And the other country, yeah, Australia, United States, Colombia, Indonesia, yeah, this is the declining of coal demand and also the export, etc. Yeah. And what we will see in the short-term impact in coal mining sector. The first one, the production until the September, the plan for this year is 550 million ton. And until September 20, the production of coal of Indonesia only 413 million ton. Yeah. The COVID-19 pandemic resulted in decreases in the national coal production because of coal demand, low coal price, and limited access of employee of mining company and mining logistic during the pandemic. This is the decreasing about 11% if compared with the same period in last year. And coal export also until the September is decreases about 13% if compared with the same period in the last year. Yeah, the last year is 338 million ton, and now until September only 295 tons. And also the domestic use, we plan about this year for the state electric company about 109, but until the September, I think, it's okay, 97, and maybe in the last year we can get the target, yeah. And but in the domestic, I think it is still good news, yeah. But the realization of non-tax state revenue, with the minister of financial has predicted that there is the decreasing of 20%. And if we see until August, 21 August, the realization, if we compare with the target is only 31 trillion. And until August, the realization only 21. Trillion. It's a big difference, yeah. And I think all the people know this decreasing of the coal price since 2018, yeah, until now. And this is the last price in October, about $51 per ton in HBA, yeah. And if we see the aku lagi anu presentasi nih Pak ya. Pak. Sorry. This is the COVID pandemic has resulted in recession in several major countries in the world, yeah. You see the global economic projection is 90% is minus in quarter 1 into this year, and quarter 2 only one country is still positive, China. Yeah. And this is the the predicted Indonesian economic growth to be weaker, yeah, along the escalation development of COVID-19. And this is the government projection in 2020 and 2021. We see also Indonesia Purchasing Manager Index, yeah, is below 50 in this year, yeah, indicating a contraction. Yeah. And what happened in the long-term impact? Yeah. In long-term impact, this is the prediction of McKinsey. Yeah. This is the demand and supply. In the left side, it is demand, and the right side is supply. Yeah. Demand is, if you compare with the last year, is decreases is 51 million ton, and the supply also, I think, decreases in 18 million ton. The current world coal supply demand condition is oversupply. And this is, if you see this graphic here, the McKinsey have divided in country Europe, Egypt, Arab and small country in Africa, and I think also the MEAR, Europe, Middle Asia, Africa, Russia, Caspian. And but it's very interesting in the color blue, dark blue, Asia. Global thermal coal demand for power is still not secure. It's the same with the period before. Yeah. And also until 2040, no significant decreasing of this demand. And we see that especially in Asia, but in America decreasing, in MEAR is decreasing, and also in China also decreasing. Yeah, especially, but we will see after the, in Asia, yeah, not divided into China, but in the green graphic. This one, this is for the middle 6 months for 2019. Yeah. It's promising also in Asia, but for the coal, but many constraint in the next period for the growing of business, coal business in all in the world. Yeah. And what happened? Coal industry in the post COVID-19 in Indonesia. Yeah. You see, this is the summary COVID. You see that mining company in Indonesia have the best procedure for health and safety. Yeah. But you see that the reporting for the government increasing for the COVID situation in each mine. And there is the report for three thousand ninety and 65 company report to the government about the condition of close contact, suspect, yeah, confirmation, and date. Yeah. And if you see, there is a close contact about 640, suspect is about 450, confirmation of 440, yeah. And all the people who working in the mine, coal mining and the other mining, mineral, have the rapid test, yeah, and also swab test. But there is the positive confirmation, 3,600, positive in 442 and recover 3,000 and died about 14%. Yeah. And also there is the problem of layoff of the workers. Yeah, near about 600 worker. This is the problem economic and social, and we hope the pandemic will stop not too long for Indonesia and all for the world. Yeah, this is the only statistic for the workers affected with based on age. Yeah, in mining company. Yeah, and surprise that the biggest affected with the age until from 30 to 40 years. Yeah, and for the other is more than 40 years. Yeah, about 50%. Yeah, and this is the post pandemic still. As Bu Arvidia mentioned before, there is the added value for the coal. Yeah, and we have this is the available Indonesia in blue one. Yeah, available in Indonesia and not available with yellow one. But some effort to make this added value. You will see in the next slide. Yeah, this is the coal added value plan. Yeah, there is three coal upgrading. Yeah, in this left side, and gasification plan. In the there is the cooperation with PT Bukit Asam, Pertamina, and one very air product, yeah, to build coal to DMA. Coal to DMA start in this year. Yeah, and there is briquette, yeah, in PT Bukit Asam, and also coke making plants. This is the plan for the realization of added value of coal, and also. The Directorate Mineral and Coal has developed the mining 4.0 for to make the productivity high for the process, all the process of between the industry and government for the legal aspect, for the reporting of PNBP, reporting production, etc. Yeah. Also, the exploration monitoring system, etc. This is the how to increase the productivity in the government and also in the industry, mining industry. And what are the opportunity policy response to harness resilience in mining area? Many effort and go from government and industry here. This is the coal reserve resilience. I think is still for the resources and reserve. All the people know Indonesian has resources and reserve enough big, yeah. And also there is the anticipation to the export market post pandemic. Yeah, especially Indonesian and export to China and India. This is about 50%, but I think the industry and the government thinking to make the divergence of the market. Yeah, this is the I think mineral and coal sector mining policy. Yeah. For the COVID, etc. Yeah, I think this is very, very systematic. And also, this is how the industry in implementation this legal aspect to anticipate COVID-19. I think this is the very, very detailed. But many company success to stop the development of workers with the COVID-19. And the last one in my presentation, how the government incentive for mining company during the COVID-19 pandemic. Yeah. Ease of licensing mining activity, the time limit tolerance in smelter settlement, yeah, tolerance in allowed to export, yeah, according to export approval, yeah, without being subject to 20% lead fee, yeah, implementation of benchmark price for nickel ore, yeah, for the mining company and the smelter company, yeah, also about the cargo, yeah, permitted sales are permitted to use any ship, yeah, yeah, and if using national vessel, maximum carrying capacity is 15,000 deadweight tonnage, according to the Minister of Trade Regulation, and sales can use foreign currency also transaction. Import permit for personal protective equipment in mining activity and community development and empowerment fund can be deferred for the benefit of handling COVID-19 around the mining area. And also, the increase in production 2020 can be limited only to those who already have a sales contract to avoid employee layoff and meet investment target. Change that to the Minister of Energy Mineral Resources degree, yeah, number 261K related to the minimum percentage of coal sale for domestic need according to the decline in domestic coal demand. Many anticipation of government to avoid this business disruption. Yeah. The control over the decreased coal production in this year can be compensated by increasing the national coal production plan for 2021, because it is estimated that the global economy will return to growth, but not significant. Not significant. Yeah. This is also the tax incentive for 6 months. Yeah, this is the very fast anticipated for from the government. Yeah, the first one, income tax clause, in the form of decreasing of corporate income from 25% to 22%, and in the next year, 2022, to 20% for IUP and some contract. And the second, income tax clause 21, in the form of relaxation for 6 months for processing industry workers. Third, income tax clause 23, final income tax, is in the form of relaxation of 6 months for final income tax PP number 23 of 2018. The fourth, clause 22, income tax, in the form of relaxation for 6 months of import income tax clause 22. Fifth, income tax clause 25, in the form of income tax reduction by 30% for 6 months. And this, the last one, value-added tax, in the form of relaxation of VAT refunds, is actually accelerated for 6 months. Yeah. Another incentive is the elimination of domestic market obligation compensation payment for this year. Currently the regulations are being drafted. Thank you very much for your attention.